Good morning and welcome to our joint worship service of Cross of Christ and St. David's Lutheran Churches. And yes, I did cut my own hair. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter, or what is commonly called Good Shepherd Sunday. So thank you for joining us. And let's just take a moment now as we quiet our hearts and minds and prepare for worship. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us sing together our gathering hymn, Savior, Like a Shepherd, Lead Us. Shepherding God, lead us through our darkest valleys.
Lead us into the way of life.
Shepherding God, guide us away from greed and envy.
Lead us into peace and justice.
Shepherding God, gather us together as your flock.
Lead us to be a community of forgiveness and peace.
Come, let us worship our shepherding God, who calls each of us by name,
follow Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, our shepherd, you know your sheep by name and lead us to safety through the valleys of death. May we not wander from his flock, but follow wherever he leads us, listening for his voice and staying near him, until we are safely in your fold to live with you forever. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We continue with our readings from Scripture.
Doing the right things does not guarantee that one will not experience difficulties, hardship, rejection, or even suffering. Here, Christ is presented as the model for our path of endurance and loyalty to God, particularly amid adversity. A reading from the first letter of Peter. It is a credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you are doing right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that free from sins, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed. For you were going astray like sheep, but now you have returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will now read Psalm 23 responsively. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want.
The Lord is my God in green pastures, and leads me beside still waters.
You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 10th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God, our Creator, and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The Easter celebration continues as we celebrate our risen and living Lord on this fourth Sunday of Easter. Also on this day, we celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday, a favorite day of mine on the church calendar. As many of you know, I love lambs, sheep, and shepherds. I have numerous sheep and lambs in my home and at my office at church. I have a sheep calendar. Each year, my Christmas tree is decorated with lambs, sheep, and shepherd ornaments. I have lamb potholders, kitchen towels, salt and pepper shakers, a napkin holder, a cookie jar. I could go on and on describing my adorable lamb and sheep collection. But I don't just love lambs and sheep because they are cute and fluffy. I love them because I was once a lost sheep. I had strayed from the flock. I had questions and maybe even doubts. But the Lord welcomed me back into the flock. And with God's help, I was able to develop a deeper, more meaningful relationship with the Good Shepherd. I also appreciate the lamb, sheep, and shepherd imagery we find in the Bible, which are mentioned over 500 times. In addition to being a major sacrificial animal, sheep provided the ancients with meat, milk, fat, wool, skins, and horns. The economic value of sheep stands in direct proportion to the amount of guidance and protection they receive. There is much imagery and theological symbolism with lambs, sheep, and shepherds in the church. The Old Testament is full of sheep and shepherd imagery, with God pictured as the shepherd of the chosen people. In the Middle East, the relationship between the shepherd and the sheep differs from anything we know. The shepherd stays with his flock to tend and care for it. Because the shepherd and sheep spend so much time together, a special intimate relationship develops between them. The primary description of a shepherd is one who guards while guiding. Shepherds move around the territory to better sources of grass and water. The shepherd leads sheep out in front, leading the way. From the front, the shepherd could scout new areas and guard against predators or rough terrain. The primary characteristic of a shepherd is faithfulness. Shepherds protect their flock even to the point of laying down one's life for the sheep. The primary prerequisite of the shepherd is compassion. Compassion is that feeling of distress for another to the degree that the affliction is felt by both. Compassion includes involvement. The shepherd knows the sheep, their needs, and their tendencies. The shepherd symbolized a royal caretaker of God's people. God denounced false shepherds and promised to provide the true shepherd, the Messiah, to care for the sheep. The entire chapter 10 of John's Gospel deals with the Good Shepherd and his flock. In today's Gospel reading, Jesus talks about the gate, even calling himself the gate. At night back then, having gathered the sheep into an enclosure or pen, the shepherd would lie down at the pen's opening so that no sheep could escape without waking the shepherd. Jesus' listeners would have understood that image of him being the gate for the sheep. It was a way of saying he wants to protect us as a shepherd protects the sheep. In verse 3, we read, he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. Jesus is our bleeding, redeeming, seeking, accepting, and transforming shepherd. He calls us to himself. In him we have a new beginning. In Christ, barriers and tensions are washed away. When we come to the Lord and say, cleanse me, wash me, love me, and give me a new heart for the sake of the Good Shepherd, God embraces us and blesses us. Please know that God loves you. You are God's child. Through baptism, you were welcomed into the Lord's family and marked with the cross of Christ forever. And you were called by name. We are the sheep of his pasture. Even though we sometimes wander or get lost, we are part of the flock of Jesus. Even in the midst of tragedy, how comforting it is to know that Jesus is our shepherd. Even in life and death struggles, even during a pandemic, Jesus is with us to guide us, to comfort and strengthen us. He is our Good Shepherd. The 23rd Psalm is the Psalm for Good Shepherd Sunday. It is a profession of joyful trust in the Lord as Good Shepherd King. I have read an interesting tidbit of information about the original Hebrew of Psalm 23. There are exactly 26 words before and 26 words after, "Thou art with me." Perhaps the poet was boldly declaring that God being with us is at the very center of our lives. God is with us. We are not alone down here. The whole gospel is that God is with us. Jesus was called Emmanuel, which means God with us. God does not shelter us from trouble. God does not magically manipulate everything to suit us. But the glorious with is unchangeable, and it is the only fact that matters. God is with us today, every day, even or especially through hardship. For the first three verses of Psalm 23, God is spoken of in the third person. The Lord is my shepherd, he leads me, he restores my soul. But with the thou, the third person shifts to second person. For thou art with me, thy God, thou preparest a table. Instead of talking about God, the psalmist begins to talk to God. Instead of God in the head, God is a friend in the heart. A conversation happens. A relationship grows. This is faith, the only true comfort. Jesus is the good shepherd who cares for all his flock. He calls us by name. He knows us more intimately than we know ourselves. No matter how far we stray, this shepherd will track us down, cradle us in his arms, and bring us home gently on his shoulder. We are his sheep. We are the ones whom Jesus loves. We are the ones for whom Jesus gave his life. We are the ones in Jesus' care now, day and night, especially through these challenging times. Although we are not able to gather together yet, you belong to his flock. Advice I find myself giving these days as we practice social distancing and miss each other so much contain these words. Stay calm. Stay healthy. Stay home. Stay safe. But most important of all, stay connected to the Good Shepherd. He cares for us. He will get us through these difficult days. You may have noticed I am wearing my white Easter chasuble. It was a gift from St. David's when I was called to serve at Cross of Christ. While it is to be worn when celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion, and somewhat inappropriate to wear today for service of the Word, I wanted to show the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Let us look forward to that day when I can wear this chasuble appropriately, and we can gather as people of God to celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion. This day, we continue to celebrate our risen and living Lord, but let us also celebrate Jesus as the Good Shepherd. The one who cares for us, the one who protects us, and the one who will get us through these difficult days. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Rejoicing in the wonder of new life in Jesus Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those who are in need, with a series of petitions, each ending with the words, God of new life, and all responding with, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Shepherding God, strengthen those who preach, teach, and pray, those who seek the lost and remember the forgotten, those who keep vigil with the dying, and all who minister to your people. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Guiding God, raise up leaders who govern not by evil but good, not by partiality but equality, not by greed but generosity of spirit, seeking not their own will but yours alone. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Protecting God, watch over all who are threatened, all who are vulnerable, all who work to guard us and take care of us. Let your rod and staff give them confidence that they fear no evil. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Comforting God, you carry us tenderly. We pray for those who walk through dark valleys, overshadowed by fear and anxiety, and overwhelmed with illness and suffering, especially those we name now silently in our hearts. Grant them the comfort of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, who walks with them. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Nurturing God, you desire justice for the hungry. Bless advocacy work, food pantries, and feeding ministries in our congregations. May none of our neighbors lack for basic needs. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Everlasting God, your beloved have heard your voice. You have called them by name and guided them to your side in death. We thank you for their lives of faithful witness. Assure us that you prepare a place for us at the same eternal table. God of new life,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O God, we commend ourselves and all for whom we pray, trusting in Jesus Christ, the spring of our new and eternal life.
Amen.
And now, in the words of our Savior, Christ taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Now, as we wrap up our service today, I'd like to thank you all again for joining us for worship, our two congregations, as well as all of our sister congregations throughout our synod and throughout the country. And I'd also like to encourage you all to continue to contribute as you're able to support your churches. Your help is much needed and very much appreciated. Now let us continue with our closing dialogue. Lord of life, you walk this journey with us and through us.
Lead us, Lord, lead on.
Journeying within and wrestling with the world.
Lead us, Lord, lead on.
Lead us to risk, to grow, and to tread the path you have opened for us.
Lead us, Lord, lead on.
And let us rejoice that every place is your place.
In the name of the risen Christ, we go.
And now may the God of life, who raised Jesus from the bonds of death, who sends forth the Spirit to renew the face of the earth, be merciful to you and bless you now and forever. Amen. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Go in peace, share the good news.
Thanks be to God.